In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a room diagram floor plan. I'm going to be showing you how to place rooms properly, how to adjust their boundary, how to tag them and delete them if necessary. And yes, deleting rooms is far more complicated than what you might think. And finally, we're going to be creating a color scheme and a legend. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content where I go slowly step by step over all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And I'm going to be using this project for this demonstration. It's my simple house in Revit. I have a whole course on this building, but for now, let's jump here to the floor plan and let's get started. So first, we need to create a new floor plan for our room diagram. So what I'm going to do is find that floor plan here in the project browser. I'm going to right click and then go duplicate view. And you want to avoid duplicate with detailing because you don't want all of this detailing inside of your room legend or room diagram. So I'm just going to hit here duplicate, and now as you can see, it's a lot simpler, but we can make it simpler yet by going here and setting the level of detail to coarse, and as you can see, it's a lot simpler now. Okay, so now moving forward, we have to start placing some rooms. So to place rooms, what you want to do is you want to be on the architecture tab, you want to go to room and area, and here we have the room tool. Now to place rooms, you basically hover over a room, and then it's going to kind of recognize the boundary of that room. You click to place, and it's going to place that room. Now in this case, I can just go all the way around placing rooms inside of this building. Now, in a lot of cases, you want to kind of make sure you follow a certain numbering convention. It is going to start usually from 1 and then continue. In this case, I'm just going to do it like this. And then I also want to tag my balcony as a room, so I'm just going to place it like this. Now, we seem to have an error here, and we also seem to have some additional errors. So let's hit the escape key a couple of times, and now let's see what's going on with these rooms. Now, room boundaries are something that's really important to think about. So what I want to show you is basically where those rooms are. Now, if you click just on the tag, it's only a tag, it's not the entire room. You can kind of hover over the X, and then you can kind of specify the room. However, my favorite approach is to go to visibility graphics overrides, go here into edit, and then find rooms. And then for the rooms, we have the interior fill option. You hit apply. Okay. And now it's going to highlight all of those rooms. Now it's a little bit better and easier to see what the boundary of the room is. So here, for example, we have this water closet, and I don't like the fact that it's only here where we have the wash basin. I also want the where the toilet is as well. So what I can do is I can select this wall, and then for all Revit walls in the properties panel, you're going to find room bounding. So you can just come here, uncheck that. And now, as you can see, this room will kind of stretch out all the way and come to this part. Now, as I said, any wall that you select, it's going to have that room bounding. In this case, I only wanted it to turn off here in this bathroom. Now, for the rest of this house, for example, we have basically, this is a living room with a dining area, and then we have a kitchen here, and it's all one room. I don't want that. So for cases such as this one, I can come here and use a room separator, and it's basically a line that tells Revit, okay, this is a separation line between two rooms. I can hit the escape key a couple of times now, and then I can come in and place a new room here for that kitchen. We have a similar situation outside here where we have this balcony, but it says not enclosed because it's, well, it's everywhere. So you can create enclosure by using that same room separator. So I can come here to room separator, and then I can go from here, go to the edge, then go from that edge down, and finally finish it off here at this wall. And now it's no longer kind of undefined, it has the area here, and you can see it now encompasses the whole kind of balcony area of this house. Now let's uncheck the visibility of all of these rooms. So I'm just going to go here to visibility graphics, overrides, find rooms once again, and then I'm just going to check that off and hit apply. Okay, so now as you can see, we're back to our original view. Now let's talk about the room tags for a second. For room tags, you can select that room tag, and then here you can make some changes. So if I click here on room, I can say this is living room. Okay, I can actually change the number too. So for example, here, I don't like the fact that the balcony here has a number 10 and then the kitchen is 11. I would like the balcony to be the last number. So I can come here to the kitchen, I can rename this at 10, and then this I can rename to 11. You can see that it did give us a kind of a warning telling us that, well, you already have a room with this number. Okay, so now moving forward, when it comes to changing room numbers, if I change this to something like 20, what you'll notice is that next time when I place a room like this, you can see that this room is now room 21. So basically, Revit is going to figure out what you want to be kind of your starting point, and then it's going to number it from there. So just something to keep in mind. In this case, I'm just going to rename this back to 11. Also, for this room tag, you can select it, and then here in the properties panel, you can go with volume instead of area. In this case, it's not computed, so let's just stick with area only. And then also, if you want to make some further changes, you can always go here to family editor, and then you can make some changes to this family. You can play around with the labels, so on and so forth. In this case, I'm just going to close it and load it back into the project. Now let's talk about deleting rooms. Remember how we have this room here? If I select it and hit delete, you might think, well, now this room is deleted. Well, it's actually not. So let me show you what I mean. What you want to do is you want to go here to the project browser, find schedules and quantities, right click, create a new schedule. And now we want to have a room schedule. So let's find rooms, click OK. And then I'm going to pick out area, name and number for our fields, and click OK. So that's going to generate us a room schedule. Now what you'll see here is when I look at the numbers, here we have number 21, that's the room which we have deleted, and it's also going to say here not placed. So even if it was deleted, it's still going to appear here as a not placed room. So you can just select it here in the schedule and then hit delete, and that's going to delete that room forever. Okay, so going back to our floor plan now, and let's now bring this to life with some color. So what you want to do for a color scheme is you want to go here to the architecture tab, you then want to go to room and area, expand this drop menu and open up color schemes. Here you want to figure out a scheme, so in this case this is just going to go according to rooms, and then we can set it here. You can see we have the option to go with name or department, the title is Room Legend, and then for color it's going to go according to the name. Now in this case, because it didn't change a lot of these room names, we only have a few because it's just following the names. However, if I were to change this to number, okay, it's going to give me way more of these for each particular number. Now, if I just hit apply and okay, we can see that nothing really happened. And the reason for that is we have to adjust this in the view properties for each of the views. In this case, I only want it in this view. So I'm just going to go here to properties, scroll down to color schemes, and then go here and it's set to none. I'm just going to change this to rooms by name, apply. Okay, and now as you can see, we have this color scheme. Now, of course, if you're not happy with that color scheme, you can always go back here to color schemes, and then here you can adjust the color, so you can change the color to whatever you want. Here it can be a solid fill, but also you can change it to be some sort of a pattern. So here, if I set this to something dark, as you can see, it can have a pattern like this. Now I'm just going to cancel out of this because I don't want to make that change. If you want to add a legend, just to give you a bit more information of what the colors are telling us, you can always go here to the annotate tab, then you can go to color fill, legend, click on that, and then place it. So basically, in this case, because we have set it according to numbers, it's going to look like this. However, I do have this project where I have set this up a little bit better. And as you can see here, we have this room legend going according to the room names. And we have kind of specified the colors a little bit better. So it's just a nicer display aesthetically. And you can see that somewhere we have solid color fill and some places we have this pattern. And of course, something that you'll notice here, even though for the garage, we don't have the pattern, it's just the floor pattern is kind of going through this color, and that's why it's displayed like this. So you would have to modify the room or the floor pattern if you don't want that to show on your room diagram. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.